To the virtual Greater Boston Church of Spiritualism on this wonderful Sunday morning of spring. Please join me in our opening prayer. Infinite Spirit, beloved God, we ask your blessing today as we gather in community and in harmony with each other. Fill us with your light and your love. Open our hearts and our minds so that we may truly understand who we are as divine beings as a part of you. We ask that you bring our loved ones with us today so that we may truly know that life and love continues into eternity. We ask special blessings upon all those who are sick, all those who are working hard to help humanity, to keep our world going. Protect our healthcare workers, our delivery drivers, our food industry people, and help to eradicate this virus so that we may move forward and create a beautiful world with you in our hearts. Amen. And today we're going to have some inspiration about one of our wonderful pioneers. I had asked some of my students to research a pioneer of spiritualism so that everyone can get an idea of the wonderful pioneers and the hard work that they did to bring this religion forward. So today I'm going to tell you a little bit about Harriet Wilson, and this was researched by Alisa Kupperman. Today we remember Harriet Wilson, an African-American spiritualist, Boston Children's Lyceum creator, writer, speaker, healer, and trance medium. To the general public, Harriet Wilson is known as the first published African-American author. She wrote it in 1859 to raise enough money to be reunited with her son. But unfortunately, he died right after at the age of 7. Her novel was rediscovered in 1982 and became a revelation. From 1867 and for the next 30 years, Mrs. Hattie E. Wilson was active in the spiritualist movement and was listed in the Banner of Light as a trance reader and lecturer. She spoke at camp meetings, in theaters, and in private homes throughout New England, and she shared the podium with famous speakers of the time. She even traveled to Chicago and spoke there as a delegate to the American Association of Spiritualists convention. Harriet was crucial in the development and organization and maintenance of Children's Progressive Lyceum, the Spiritualist Sunday Schools, which started here in Boston. Wilson was known as the colored medium. We are filled with so much compassion for what it must have felt like to be labeled and continuously discriminated. There is poetic justice in that Harriet Wilson's legacy has been rediscovered in our time, and the woman once dubbed the colored medium continues to teach others about tolerance. The Harriet Wilson Project was organized to remember her legacy, and there is now a statue in her hometown in Milford, New Hampshire, to honor her. Long in spirit but not forgotten, Harriet Wilson continues to teach and inspire us. Harriet would want us to know that it's important to not give up on yourself when faced with challenges. Reinvent yourself and remain connected to spirit and to being of service. You are always supported and guided by your friends on the other side. So we give great thanks to Harriet Wilson for the work she did and the work she continues to do from the spirit side of life. And now if you would join me with a healing prayer, and the words will show up on your screen. I ask the great unseen healing force to remove all obstruction from my mind and body and to restore me to perfect health. I ask this in all sincerity and honesty, and I will do my part. I ask this great unseen healing force to help both present and absent ones who are in need of help and to restore them to perfect health. I put my trust in the love and the power of God. Amen. And now it's time for a healing meditation, a time where we can let go of the busyness and the stress of life and open up to that divine healing power that is all around us, that exists within us. It's a time where we remember that the divine presence is never away from us and we can never be separate. So I ask you to just get comfortable wherever you are. Take a nice deep breath and close your eyes and allow yourself to relax as you focus on your breath, breathing in and breathing out, and allowing that breath to relax you and soothe you and calm you. And as you breathe in, imagine God's healing light flowing in with your breath, moving into your lungs, healing and clearing. Feel it moving through your bloodstream, reaching into every cell and every particle, reminding every cell of its perfect state and awakening the light within every single cell of your body. And as you breathe out, release the stress, the strain, the tension, the fear, and the worry you may be holding in those cells. Just allow everything to fall away as you breathe out. And every breath you take in carries more light and brings you into the present moment of now. For in this moment, we are one with the presence of God. The past is over, so we remove ourselves from the past. The future has not come, so we can let that go as well. And simply focus on this present moment where we know the presence of God exists. Breathing it in, allowing that light to awaken within us the light that has always been there. Awaken that divine spark at the core of our being. Every breath we feel our bodies relaxing as this divine healing light moves from the top of our head all the way down to the tip of our toes, filling every muscle, every nerve, every bone and every joint. Just allow that light to continue to flow and to bring to you what you need. And continuing to breathe that light in, feel every particle in your body filled with light. And that light expanding through your pores so that every part of that body is filled with light and that light is returning you to your natural state of ease and peace and harmony within. Feeling every system working together with every other. Every cell working in harmony with every other, creating health and well-being. And as you allow your body to relax, feel that light continuing to flow into your mind. Breathing it in, feeling it flowing through your mind like a peaceful river of light. And allow all of those busy thoughts to flow away in that river. Letting go of all of our thoughts, watching them flow away, so that nothing has our attention but this light, but this love. And as this river of light flows through our mind, you feel your mind quieting and opening. You feel your mind lifting and expanding into that higher mind where you know who you are as a part of God, as a spirit. you lift higher and higher and feel that divine light filling you with the knowing that you are loved beyond measure, that all is well, that you are cared for, that you are loved. And allow that divine light to flood your mind, opening you to the inspiration, to the wisdom, to the guidance that is here for you right now. For you are never alone. Allow this knowledge to move through your mind and body, renewing and restoring your spirit. Feel this divine light washing over your emotional body, clearing away the pains and hurts of yesterday, clearing away the grief and sorrow, the fear and the worry, all the negative emotions that may have been stuck in that emotional body. Just allow the divine life, the healing power, the unconditional love to wash over it, to wash it away, to cleanse you and clear you of anything that would block you from knowing who you are as a being of love. Anything that blocks you from loving, allow it to flow away. For you are a being of love. You were created in love and as love and of love. So allow the truth of your being to rise as your heart begins to open with pure love. And you know that you are in unity and in harmony within yourself and with the divine presence. And as you breathe and relax, imagine yourself being lifted. Lifted to a beautiful mountain path. And imagine yourself feeling the earth beneath your feet. Walking along a beautiful winding path and noticing all the beauty around you. Just when you least expect it, you see a flower bursting forth from the earth. You notice the trees and all their wonder and glory as you move along this mountain path, climbing higher and higher with each step. But all along the pathway, there are little paths leading to respites, to places of rest, where you can take a break from the climb and simply be, allowing yourself to be renewed and restored. And you see a beautiful little path just before you, calling to you to follow. So you walk along this little path. And at the end of the path, you see a magnificent waterfall, very top of the mountain, but gently falling all the way down, creating a beautiful pool. And as you look at that waterfall, you can see every color of the rainbow flowing through that water. And so you step into that pool to be cooled, to be calmed, to be renewed. And you feel the rays of all of those colors filling you. You feel the red filling you with strength, the power to continue the climb, to continue on. You feel the orange filling you, awakening your creativity, your passion, and your joy. You feel the yellow of positivity flowing over you, helping you to see the best in every situation. You feel the radiant green filling you with life force, bringing you the power to live fully as who you are, bringing you the healing that you need to continue on. You feel a beautiful blue now flowing around you and through this pool. And that blue brings you a deep peace. And in that peace is a knowing that all is well. And as you take in that knowing, you feel a beautiful lavender color flowing around you and through you and awakening your divine spirit so that you may stand as the spirit you are, vibrant and alive and ready to move forward on your path. And as all the colors fill you and bring to you what you need, you feel the rays of God's white light moving through you, around you, filling you, and bringing to you that union that you so desire. Bringing to you that oneness of being with the divine source. or your source is always there. That infinite spirit, divine creator, is there within you and constantly nurturing you and feeding you. For you are a spirit of God, and you can never be separated from your source. And as this light flows around you, you know that you are safe, that all is well, and that you have all that you need within you to carry on your journey of life. Take a nice deep breath and take in all of those colors, all of that love, all of that healing light. And feel yourself gently moving back toward that path, rejoining that mountain path, that climb to the top. And knowing you have all that you need within you to continue your journey of life in a state of ease and a state of grace. For you are always connected, always one. And feel yourself gently being carried back to the room, feeling your body sitting wherever you're sitting, feeling the clothes upon it. But as you come back, you know that you have all that you need within you. You are one and complete. You are whole, for you are in union with your divine source. Take a nice deep breath. And as you do, open your eyes and smile and realize who you really are as a magnificent spirit of God, shining brightly in this earth and living each moment as that spirit, knowing all is well and you have all that you need within you. And now if you join me, if we're all back and awake, join me in reciting our Declaration of Principles. In spiritualism, we have no rules or regulations, no dogmas or creeds, but we do have a set of principles that help us to live our lives in the best possible way. So please read them with me. They will appear on the bottom of the screen. We believe in infinite spirit and that God is infinite spirit. We believe that the phenomena of nature, both physical and spiritual, are the expression of infinite spirit. We affirm that a correct understanding of such expression and living in accordance therewith constitute true religion. We affirm that the existence and personal identity of the individual continue after the change called death. We affirm that communication with the so-called dead is a fact scientifically proven by the phenomena of spiritualism. We believe that the highest morality is contained in the golden rule. Whatsoever ye would that others should do unto you, do ye also unto them. We affirm the moral responsibility of the individual and that they make their own happiness or unhappiness as they obey nature's physical and spiritual laws. We affirm that the doorway to reformation is never closed against any human soul, here or hereafter. And we affirm that the precepts of prophecy and healing contained in the Bible are divine attributes proven through mediumship. So this week we celebrate Patriots Day. And as we do, we think about those brave souls who fought for our freedom. We also think about the Boston Marathon, which has been a part of Boston for well over 100 years. And a part of our lives as long as I know I can remember. But we also think about the Boston Marathon bombing. And when I think about that, I think of all those brave souls who ran toward the blast instead of away from it. So today we are honoring all those people who stood up to their fear and faced life with courage and fought for helping others, and really allowed themselves to rise up and be the best they could be. We think about all those brave souls who are out there every day in the hospitals working to help those who have been infected by the virus. And we know that they are facing amazing challenges and facing their fears and courageously going forward. So we thank them and we honor them for the good work that they're doing. We think about the challenges that our Patriots faced. And we think about our Patriots were simply men who left their farms and went off to fight for the freedom of this country, for the higher good of everyone. They put themselves last and put the higher good first, a lesson we all need to learn. We think about the women who were left behind to raise the children and farm the lands. And we think about the pioneers of this great religion and what they did to stand up against equality and to fight for the rights of women and the rights of everyone. We think about the challenges that face our healthcare workers each and every day, and we know how difficult it must be. We all face challenges every day. Life will always bring us challenges because that's what life is about. We are all on a spiritual journey, and our journey is filled with challenges because that's how we grow. That's how we learn. So we're all facing challenges right now. And it's how we face those challenges and what we do with them that really matters. So let's ask ourselves, how am I facing the challenges of each and every day? I have a story for you. You know, I love stories. And this story is about a donkey, a wonderful little donkey who fell into a well. Well, when he fell into the well, he was so frightened and he was crying out for help and baying until the farmer came along and found him. And the farmer looked into the well and he thought, how am I going to lift this donkey out of the well? It's so deep, I can't reach him and he's too heavy. So he called all his farmer friends, and all the farmers from around came and stood around that well, and they all looked to see the poor little donkey down at the bottom of the well. And they all thought and thought and thought, and they couldn't come up with a way to get the donkey out of the well. So finally they decided that they would put the poor donkey out of his misery and bury him in the well. So the farmers began to pick up shovels of dirt and throw it down into the well. Well, at first, the donkey was terrified, right? What's this dirt coming down on top of me? But you know what the donkey did? He shook it off, patted it down, and stepped up on it. So every shovel full of dirt that went down, that hit the donkey, he shook it off his body, patted it down, and stepped up. He could have easily stayed in his fear and let the dirt bury him, but he didn't. He used every shovelful that went down to shake it off, pat it down, and step up. Hours went by because this was a very deep well, and the farmers worked for hours and hours trying to fill that well. And after many hours of hard labor, that donkey walked right out of that well. Great story, isn't it? But the donkey did what we need to do. The donkey took small action steps, used what life gave him, and achieved his goal. Isn't that what we need to do with the challenges of life? To see the blessing in those challenges, to use them wisely, and to grow from them. So that was a very wise donkey. And we take from him the positive action steps that we can take in our lives, because each and every day we all have different challenges. Some of us are going off to work in the healthcare industry. Some are staying home and trying to work from home. Some are trying to school their children and work from home. Some people are on computers all day long and on Zoom meetings all day. And some people are all by themselves facing yet one more day alone without physical contact. So everyone has challenges, and we're all facing them in very different ways because we're all unique. But if we can take small action steps to make our day better, then we will reach our goal and we will come through this and return to a new state of normalcy. So I put together just a few action steps that we can take. And the first one is, wake up and say thank you for this life. For life is truly a gift. And if we wake up in the morning, that's a good day, because so many people are not. There are so many people dying from this virus. So if we're alive, we need to say thank you for this wonderful gift, because life is a gift. It's an amazing gift. And we see that in a newborn baby, don't we? When a newborn baby is placed in our arms, it is such a gift to us. It brings us such joy. And we see that baby as a gift. And we see that the life within that baby is an amazing gift. But do we ever think that we were once those infants? We were once those babies bringing new life into the world, bringing a gift, an amazing gift to the world. So when we wake up in the morning, we need to realize, wow, I am a gift to the world, and this life is a gift to the world and a gift to everyone. And we need to see ourselves through new eyes. I don't know when we take for granted our life, but we do, don't we? So let's think about ourselves as being reborn every morning when we wake up and say thank you to God for this life. Help me to use it in the best possible way. And one of those ways is to set an intention of what we want to achieve in our day, what we want to do. You know, we're all in different straits, and some of us are home, and there's a lot of home projects that we've probably been putting off for many years. I know I have. But if we can take things a little bit at a time and just take small action steps, you know, if you have a closet to clear out, take just a piece of it. I know I'm working on a porch that can take me a very long time, but if I give it an hour every day, I accomplish something. You know, that sense of accomplishment, no matter what it is important for us to have. It awakens us. It helps us feel joyful about who we are and what we can do in our lives and in our day. I recently heard I heard a commencement speech, and unfortunately I can't remember who gave it. But it was a most amazing piece of information that was I found so helpful. And this gentleman was giving the speech. He said, we have to start each day with a sense of accomplishment. And the one way we can do this is by making our bed. Now, how easy is that? You put your feet on the floor, you turn around and roll up the covers and fluff the pillows. Bed is made. But by making that bed, you have accomplished something in your day. So you start your day with a sense of accomplishment. And you continue on through the day knowing that it's possible to accomplish anything because you've already done it. So use that sense of accomplishment throughout your day. Choose what it is you'd like to accomplish today. And make them small steps. Don't overextend, don't take too much. Just give yourself one thing to find joy in. Because when we work on little projects, we find joy there. You know I found just clearing out that porch in a little bit of time, I find all kinds of treasures. I actually decorated my whole kitchen for Easter with what I found on my porch. So you never know what treasures you'll find. You may choose, today I'm going to clean out that junk drawer that's so full of stuff I don't know what's in it. And you find treasures. So part of that intention is to find the joy in the mundane things of life, in the little things that surround you, because we're all surrounded by blessings, whether we know it or not. There are a million gifts, and I know that the spirit world is working with us to uplift us all the time, to help us find those little moments of joy, because that will uplift us and help us move forward. Another thing we need to do is love and honor ourselves on every level and layer. You know, we're physical beings. We need to eat healthy. We need to feed ourselves, feed these bodies what they need to be healthy. We want to build our immune system so that we don't get sick during this time. So feed your body something healthy every day. And the other thing is to move your body. You know, whether you're exercising or doing a video on TV or doing Tai Chi or yoga, dance. But get that body moving, because our bodies want to move and we're not out as much as we were. So move that body. I know I saw Dominic doing street dancing. They were 3 feet apart in Scotland on this country road, all dancing and moving their bodies, because everyone knows how important exercise is and we all need to get out there and do it. But make sure you're, like they were, socially distancing yourselves. So that's the physical, but what about the mental? What are you putting in your mind each and every day? Shut off the news. Don't watch it for a few days. You'll know when things change. Believe me, we'll all know. But allow yourself to fill your mind with something inspiring. You know, we're so lucky we have Kindles now. And we can download a book and we can get them free from the library and just put in the search engine inspiration. And all kinds of wonderful things come up. Inspiration is all around us, but we need to choose to bring it in. We need to fill our minds with positive things, inspiring things, because that will lift us through our day and help us to face the challenges before us. Our emotional bodies get stuck with fear and worry. Of course, there's fear and worry. We have to notice our emotions. We have to allow ourselves to feel them, but we don't have to wallow in them. We can allow these feelings to come up, notice them, thank them for coming, see what we want to do with them, and then release them. And the best way I have found is to stay in alignment with the divine. That's our spirit. Keep our spirit connected to the divine. And as we did in our meditation, allow that divine light to wash and cleanse our emotional bodies. Choose to release those negative emotions and transform them into peace. The other thing we need to do is let go of judgment. So much judgment in the world, and blame. If we can let go of all of that and just for a moment accept what is. Because when we accept what is, then we can make our choices of what we'll do about it. But if we fight against it, and we could see in our world so many people fought against having to stay separate from each other. It's natural, it's normal, we're all stubborn human beings, and we don't like to be told what to do. I know I don't. So we have to accept the truth of what is so we can make the choices of what we're going to do with it. And hopefully now the choice is that we will do everything in our power to eradicate this disease by staying separate from each other and following what the guidelines are. Also, spending time being grateful for the little things in life is so important. Each and every day, I always tell people to keep a gratitude journal, but each and every day, write down things that you're grateful for. So that when you go to sleep, you sleep peacefully, knowing things are okay. That's an important piece. And the last one is use your imagination to dream a new story. Fear and worry may try to creep into our dreams of a future, because it's hard to get out of the present and dream a future without this virus present. But just let them go. And begin to dream and allow your imagination to expand into what you and your life will look like in the future. We must dream. That's how we create. We are creative beings. And as we dream, we bring that into our reality a little bit closer. So I want to share one more story with you. And this story comes from Rumi. And it's called The Sound of the Splash. Well, at one time, there was a village who had a beautiful river running through it. And that was their water supply. And they were very protective of the water supply. They didn't want anyone else to come and take their water. So they built a high wall all around the river so no one from the other villages could come and take their water. And one day this man, so thirsty, he was dying of thirst, he climbed that wall and got to the top. And it was so high he couldn't even see the water. So what he did was he took a handful of mud from the wall and he threw it down and he heard the splash of the water. And in his imagination, he could feel that water splashing around him. He could imagine himself drinking that water and he felt so wonderful as he was in that water and feeling it and experiencing it. His imagination carried him into the last time he felt water. And every time he felt thirsty or hot, he would scoop up the mud and he would throw it down into the river. And that sound of the splash would transport him again into his imagination where he knew everything was okay. Well, he continued to do this for a very long time. And eventually he realized that the water was getting closer to him. For every scoop of mud that he threw, that wall was getting shorter. And so he continued to listen to that sound of the splash until he was right there in the water. Isn't that a fun story? It's amazing how we can use our imaginations to create our reality. We have very powerful tools. I know I spoke about our breath a few weeks ago, breathing in the light of God and breathing out that peace, letting go of all that fear just with our breath, and using our imagination to imagine a new world, a world living in harmony. And seeing our part in that is really what we're doing here in this time of segregation. So use your imagination. There are tools that are available to you. You know, in spiritualism, we study the laws of nature. And in the laws of creation, we realize we must first imagine what it is we want. And then through our desire, and through our small actions, we begin to vibrate, living as if it's already true, vibrate with what it is we desire so that it can be manifested in our lives. So there's a wonderful song that I can't even remember the name of it. It was out many years ago. But one of the lines was, if I can see it, I can be it. So isn't it a great idea right now to be dreaming who we want to be and what our world needs to be so that we can see what our part in creating a new world? I think we are all here to create a new world. We're not going back to the old. We're creating something new and something wonderful. We're realizing our oneness with every being on this planet, that we're not separate. We're realizing we're all the same no matter where we live, what nationality, what culture, we're all the same. So let us use these days to dream a new dream for our world and for ourselves. And remember that life is a journey. Use all the tools you have on this journey because the joy is in the journey, not the destination. You know, the finish line, it is said, is for the ego. The journey is for the spirit. So enjoy the journey. Rise up. Be all that you can be. Live fully. And don't forget to be grateful and say thank you for the amazing life that you do have. God bless you all. And thank you. Now, we will be blessed with a musical selection by Damien, LaCount. He's going to sing It's the Climb.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but There's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaking, but I gotta keep trying, gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain, I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle, sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there, ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know. Moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gotta keep going, and I gotta be strong. Just keep pushing on, 'cause there's always gonna be another mountain, always gonna wanna make it move, always gonna be an uphill battle, sometimes you're gonna have to. What's waiting on the other side is the climb. Yeah. There's always gonna be another mountain, I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle, sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there, ain't about what's waiting on the other side.
Thank you, Damien, for that beautiful song. Thank you, Rob, for the accompaniment. It's wonderful to have these videos that we can share with you each and every week from past services. And now it's time for our spirit messages. It's time when we prove that life and love continues. I know that I'm working very differently with the spirit world in these broadcasts because you're not sitting in front of me. And I'm just allowing spirit to move through me and bring the evidence and the wisdom they have. I always ask them what they learned in their life because those messages are universal for everyone. So I hope that you'll open your hearts, open your minds, and listen closely to the evidence because many spirits come in together and you may understand some pieces. Know that that's your loved one making themselves known. It's impossible to give too many individual messages working this way, but I'll do the best I can and just step out of the way and allow spirit to move through me. And if you do recognize them, you can comment or send an email just so we know that we're getting through to the loved ones who the spirit world is so anxious to connect to. Okay. Okay, I have a woman who's coming in very strongly as she comes in, and she feels very much a mother to me. She's not too tall. I feel like she's neat and tidy. And I feel like this woman would have been a nurse because she comes in with the nurse's shoes on. And I feel like she's very matter of fact and knew how to take care of business. She's a little bitty, a little tiny thing, but she packs a powerful spirit because when she spoke, people listened. And she, I feel like she would have been a boss in a nursing unit because I feel like she's the one telling people what to do and can kind of call the shots and knows how to handle things. I feel like she's really good in an emergency and she just knows how to step up. I feel like very courageous with her and adventurous with her as well, that nothing stopped her. She didn't let anything get in her way. I feel like she's coming in, she's talking about her children. Some of them are very much like her and some of them are not. She's saying that one particular child got a lot of her and another one got a lot of the father. So I feel like she's coming in to say, I did teach all of my children how to stand up and take charge and be responsible for themselves. That was like the one big lesson that she taught her children, and I feel like she has three children, and I also feel like she's coming in with her husband. Her husband is not on the heavy side. I feel like I'm in good shape with him as well. They both feel very fit, and neither one of them feel they were too old when they passed. I feel like they're coming in together. They didn't pass together, but they're back together in spirit, and they're looking out for their beautiful children on earth. I feel like their children are adults now and all living their own lives in very different ways. And what I feel like the mother is trying to say is that each one needs to go on their own journey, and that's okay. That not one of them are exactly the same. They all have their own good qualities. They were all a great gift to us, they say. But each one was a little bit different. They were unique in themselves and they've chosen different journeys. But she's proud of all of them and supportive on all the journeys that they have taken. I feel like she's, and the husband, coming together to be of support to their families as the families are moving through some challenging times. And she's letting me know that everyone is moving through challenging times. We just pull up our bootstraps and keep going. And I feel like as she's saying that, I feel the father is pulling on boots. So I feel like these are fireman boots. So I feel like he would have been in a service like a fireman or a volunteer fireman, because I feel like, oh, he's off to a fire, he's pulling on his boots. So I feel like he's also a first responder. I feel the both of them coming in like first responders and in that courageous energy. And what they're both trying to say to us all is that we all have the courage within us to stand up, to do what's right. And when we see someone who's in need of help, we just do it. We don't think about it. It's not even, I'm going to stop and look at my fear, because in those moments, you just go beyond and you become the spirit that you are, and you become and find the strength that you have within you. So don't worry about what's to come. You know that you have everything within you to rise up and handle any challenge that comes into your life. I feel like they're bringing in some humor as well and fun. And they're talking about how important it is to have a balance in life. I feel like they would have been at an extremes in their work. So in the home life, they would go to extremes in the fun. So it feels like they're creating a balance and saying, and you really work hard, you have to play hard too. And play hard in wonderful ways, in good ways. You know, really enjoy yourself when you're not in those times of stress and high working vibrations. So they're coming in to say, you know, when you're off time, relax, be at ease, don't worry about things, and just give yourself a break. So I feel like they're both trying to, they're coming in as first responders and they're trying to help us all to understand that we all have that within us. Don't look for other people to do it yourself. Stand up, be counted. And I leave you with their wonderful spirits, very pioneering they are as they come in, and very supportive and very strong. God bless you, thank you. Okay. I feel like I have another woman who's stepping in now who is much gentler and quieter than that couple. And she's coming in with a good sense of peace, and I feel like she kind of tiptoes around in her life, that she doesn't make waves. And she's coming in as someone who would have been a mother, and she also would have been a grandmother, and she would have been a sister. And she said, I had many hats. I worked outside the home. I feel like she would have worked in an office of some sort, because I'm seeing the old typewriters, so I'm going back in those old manual typewriters, and I see the little eraser pens, you know, that had the brush on the back of them. So she's taken me back to like the 60s era, and when she would have been in the workplace. But I feel like she would have tiptoed around. She didn't like to create waves. She'd like to create peace. And she's coming in to say that that was what her gift was. Her gift was not to make a big scene or make a big noise. Her gift was to be quiet, to be peaceful, and to smooth the waters for other people. And she smoothed a lot of waters. When people were upset, she could smooth things out. She wasn't someone who would who liked confrontation. In fact, she would turn away from confrontation, and she's saying that was okay for me. Some people need to learn how to deal with confrontation, but I learned in my own way in how to deal with the difficulties and the confrontations that were there for me. I did it in a much more peaceful way. I was not a fighter, and I never wanted to fight with anyone. And so she would be very quiet, but she had her way of going around things and solving issues and calming people down and making things okay. And this was her great gift. And what she's talking about today is there are a lot of us peacemakers up here, and we're all coming in to try to smooth the waters and help people be more at ease and calmer in their days, because people's nerves are on edge in a lot of places. And they're saying we're there to help calm the waters and soothe the souls. And so it's patience that everybody needs, and tolerance. And they had a lot of it. And I feel like they're coming in to say we're all there, and we know when people are reaching their high point, and we're bringing peace to them. And if you can think about the peace that is within you, that you're in charge of you, that makes a big difference. She said she could easily walk away from a fight because she knew she was in charge of her. And that was her way to say, I'm in charge of me. And when she walked away from a fight or an argument, she was empowering herself. She wasn't being a coward by walking away. She was being empowered because she was choosing to take the higher road, to be the better person, and to seek a solution somewhere else to smooth the waters. And she would wait. And she would wait till the person who was flying off the handle calmed down, and then she would be able to speak to them. But she knew when to stop and walk away. And she's saying it's something everybody needs to learn, because tempers flare, and when tempers flare, no good comes of it. So she's in here trying to help people realize Just be at peace within yourself. Allow your choices to choose peace over everything else to be what empowers you. It's a good thing, and don't forget that. Don't think you have to stand and fight toe to toe all the time. You can just walk away. It's okay, because an opportunity will arise later where you can smooth the waters, where you can resolve. She didn't run away from resolutions. She found resolutions. And so she's encouraging everybody. And I feel like there's a lot of women with her and men as well that were peacemakers. I feel like I have another gentleman stepping in who was very, very tall. And I feel like he would have worn, he's coming in a suit. I don't feel a lot of hair on his head, but he's one of these peaceful people. And I feel like he was a boss. And he had a very, he had a very soothing voice as he's speaking to me. I feel like just talking to him, he had a way of speaking slowly and quietly. And just in that slow, quiet voice, he calmed people and he stopped situations before they got out of hand. So I feel like he's definitely a boss in a business. And he has a lot of people under him, maybe in banking, because I'm seeing a big bank with him. But I feel like he was, he was a very gentle soul, and he knew how to run things. And he was highly intelligent, and he knew how to run things so that everybody felt honored. And he's talking to me about the importance of honoring people and honoring people's feelings, understanding the feelings, and then helping them to resolve the feelings. So he would be one that would take you into his office quietly and explore what was going on with you in order to resolve, rather than to put you on the carpet and reprimand you. So he was a wonderful, wonderful man, and was a peacemaker in his work. I feel like he had children. I felt two daughters with him, and I feel like he had a lovely family, and the whole family was very similar in that way of speaking softly and gently to one another. He was a great teacher to everybody in his life, and as I'm feeling his presence, I feel like he lost the ability to speak before he passed, because I keep feeling like I can't breathe really well, and I feel like he may have had a trach in his throat before he passed, or a vent, because I feel like he can't communicate with those he loved. But I feel like he survived by a lot of grandchildren. And I feel like his children are still here. He's telling me he's with his wife on the spirit side of life, who is very tiny and beautiful woman, soft and gentle here. But he's saying, I want my grandchildren to know that that's the way to go. To be patient, to be kind, to be understanding, and to talk to people and help them resolve their issues so that things are resolved instead of pushed under the rug. So I know that there are reasons why he's bringing this, especially to his grandchildren, but I feel like things can't be shoved under the rug. They need to be resolved. So he's given that to his grandchildren, but also to all of us, to resolve the issues we may have with other people. But don't do it in a fighting way. Do it in a gentle, understanding, and compassionate way. Connect to people. Ask what's making them feel that way. And let's resolve the feeling so they can truly be released and we can move on into creating a loving, harmonious world. So I give thanks to all the peacemakers who were here. There are so many of them that I feel, and they're reaching out to not just their families, but to all of us, because it's up to all of us to be the peacemakers in the world. And standing and hoping that we'll do a good job and letting us know that we have the support around us to do that. So I leave you with their love and their many, many blessings. And so I feel like I have three gentlemen coming in, and they're all coming in uniform. I feel like they're three brothers, and they have different uniforms on. So I feel like they're coming in from different branches of the U.S. military. But I also feel coming in with them are a whole lot of military people. I have a Navy admiral, and I have a whole lot of Marines coming in on this side. Funny, I have Navy on one side, Marines on the other. But I feel like they're all coming in together as Patriots. And I feel like they're coming in to help us understand that we all stand up in our own way. We fight for what is right. We step up and we take care of our duties as human beings. And I feel like they're representing many, many families here, because these are all men that fought in World War II and the Korean War. I feel I have veterans from Vietnam War coming in. There's just a room filled with soldiers. And I feel like each one of them gave their time. Some of them lost their lives as soldiers, but a lot of them performed their duty and went home to raise families and be good men in the country. And I feel like they're coming in to remind us all to remember your responsibility to your country, to your world. Remember to stand up and be who you are and be the best you can be. Take pride in your nation, because they did. They took pride in where they came from. They took pride in the good that this country had to give. So be responsible, be respectful, and honor your government by putting the best people there, and choose wisely, because it's so important to stand up for your country and to be an important part of the world. And that's what they were so proud of. All of these men fought for their country, and they were proud of their country. And they're wanting you to bring back that glory, because I'm seeing their old glory being waved. So I feel like they're coming in because of Patriots Day, but they're coming in because they belong to all of you. So many of you have fathers and grandfathers that fought in the wars, and they fought for the higher good of all. And that seems to be the theme today from the spirit world, is to remember the higher good of all. Let us all do our part to create the higher good for everyone, not just ourselves. And these men are here to stand proud and strong in who they were, and they're telling you to be proud of who you are. Stand up and be counted, and do what you can to make your world a better place. So I leave you with their love and their many, many blessings, and all of the support they have as they come in around you, loving you and uplifting you. And we give thanks to all of those on the spirit side of life who have drawn near today to help us understand that life and love does continue. I remind you that there's not enough time to give everyone a message, and maybe you didn't feel your loved ones here today, but know that each and every one of you has been touched by the love of spirit. So please take their love in and send it out to them. They do get it. They hear what you're saying. They feel the love that you flow out into the world, and they want you to feel theirs. So as we close our service, I just want to remind you that we will be here each and every Sunday for as long as we can. And to remind you that we do need donations to be made to the Greater Boston Church of Spiritualism. You can go on our website, hit the donate button. No amount is too small. We do have bills that we have to pay to keep us going. So we appreciate the generosity of all of you out there to keep us present and keep us working and bringing through the messages of spirit. So thank you for being with us today. And I will now say a closing prayer. Infinite Spirit, beloved God, we thank you for the love, the healing, for the grace and the peace that you have brought to us today. Fill our hearts, fill our minds, fill our spirits, and help us to move forward to be the best that we can be. Help us to face each challenge that every day brings, in the best possible way, and to live our lives as the spirits we were created to be. Help us to remember that we are magnificent parts of you, and may we celebrate the blessings that surround us each and every day until we meet again. Amen. Thank you for being with us. God bless you all.